When you go to the doctor with certain symptoms, one of the things that could come up is thyroid. And you're hearing about this, I'm hearing about this among friends a lot. It plays a bigger role in your health than you might have ever understood. So Dr. Sharon Thompson from Central Phoenix Obstetrics and Gynecology is joining us this Monday morning with what we should know and when we should be asking our doctors about this. Good morning.
Good morning. So your thyroid gland is so important. It controls almost everything in your body, from your sleep to your moods, how fast your heart beats, your weight.
Wow.
So it controls everything. And so it can cause all sorts of symptoms that you might not necessarily associate with your thyroid. In fact, most people will not. Mm-hmm. So if you're starting to feel really fatigued, you're like, oh, why am I so tired? Well, one, if you're a woman, you could be pregnant. So always check that first.
Cross that off the list. Make sure process of elimination, yes.
But if you're starting to feel fatigued, or conversely, you have energy, like an Energizer bunny. No one can keep up with
you. Well, no one's going to complain about that.
And very few people do, so it takes a while to get diagnosed.
Okay.
Because if you have more energy, you're like, I'm getting more done.
This is great.
Fantastic. But it can also affect your periods if you're a woman. It can affect your moods. Mm-hmm. You're irritable or depressed. Your weight. You start losing weight rapidly or gaining weight. All those things can be associated with your thyroid.
Interesting.
So there's a reason to go see your doctor.
So I imagine people go in and maybe they're complaining about the emotional stuff, or they're saying, oh, I feel depressed, or oh, I'm worried about my weight, or am I starting menopause, or you think maybe everything but.
Exactly.
Okay.
And so the good news is that most doctors, most primary care doctors, OBGYNs,
they know
that it could be your thyroid. Mm-hmm. So that's one of the first things that we check for. And it could be something as simple as you're sweating more than you used to.
Oh, interesting.
And so that's a sign that something may be going on.
How do you check for any problems?
So there's a simple blood test that we do.
Okay.
And that blood test can tell us, because our thyroid is controlled by our brains.
Okay.
And so we check for a brain hormone that's telling the thyroid either function or stay the same.
Oh.
And so we look at the level of that hormone. So pretty easy.
Is there something that you can do in terms of a physical or self-exam? I mean, do people notice a change in? Okay.
No, because the thyroid is well hidden. It's actually part of it is down under your collarbone.
Okay.
So you won't really notice anything unless it's a massive problem.
Mm-hmm.
But so most people won't and can't, thank goodness, self-diagnose. Mm-hmm. But if you have those symptoms, definitely go in and ask your doctor, hey, what's going on with me?
Okay, so you go in, doctor's going to hopefully give you a test and figure out you've got some of the symptoms that may lead you to determining that the thyroid is the issue. And all of these things you want to contact the doctor about.
Definitely. And if you have severe symptoms, severe vomiting, new chest pain, new dizziness that doesn't go away, confusion, it might not be your thyroid, but those are serious symptoms and you should be seen. And like we said, a simple blood test. Sometimes it can be something more serious that requires medication or even surgery, but that simple telling your doctor your symptoms, getting that simple blood test is a place to start.
And then how do you treat it?
So it depends on what the issue is.
Okay.
Your thyroid can be over-functioning. Mm-hmm. That's where you get all the energy, you get hyper, or it can be under-functioning. If it's over-functioning, we can give medicines to kind of calm it down a little bit. If it's under-functioning, we can replace thyroid hormone. Fortunately, most thyroid problems are easily treated.
Okay.
So it's not one of those things where you're like, oh, I'm going to die tomorrow. Mm-hmm. You know, people often stay home because they worry about what the diagnosis will be. Thyroid problems are easy to diagnose, easy to treat, so definitely go in if you think something's going on.
Good to hear. Dr. Thompson, thank you so much.
Oh,
Wellness with Dr. Thompson. We appreciate your perspective so much.